Hi, and welcome to the News-Sentinel's wrap-up of Tuesday's primary election. We are here in the News-Sentinel newsroom, and I am Kevin Leininger, reporter and columnist, and with me is...
I'm News-Sentinel reporter Christian Schekler.
And thank you for joining us. Well, of course, Christian, the big story Tuesday was Richard Murdoch's stunning defeat, not so much in terms of the defeat itself, but the margin over longtime incumbent Richard Lugar on the Republican U.S. Senate primary side. To what do you attribute not only the victory itself, but also the margin in which it was accomplished?
Boy, I think obviously all the Tea Party folks really came out strong, and Murdoch really had a lot of momentum. I think his campaign did a really good job, painting Lugar the way they wanted to, and I think that showed, and I don't think Lugar's campaign did a very good job from the get-go, portraying Murdoch the way they would like him, would like voters to have seen him.
Right. I talked to a lot of Tea Party people at Republican headquarters Tuesday night, and they were giddy almost at having defeated Lugar, and I told them, and hopefully they'll listen for their own sake, that they really have not won anything yet. The Democrats are really gearing up for the fall now. They think having Murdoch on the ticket will be a little easier to beat than Lugar was. I'm not sure I buy that, but certainly the election itself is not a done deal simply because they've defeated Richard Lugar.
Yeah, I don't think Joe Donnelly is going to have an easy time for sure beating Murdoch. I think Murdoch is probably the stronger candidate given the state's obvious advantage to Republicans.
Just maybe one last comment on that. I think above all, Lugar was hurt by the fact that he had simply been around for 35 years. And a lot of people, even those inclined to like him, I think said, you know, that's really long enough. Let's go in another direction. Speaking of other directions, let's go down our list of other topics we probably should cover. Allen County Council right now is all Republican. You've got the three nominees, including now the two incumbents, Bob Armstrong and Roy Buskirk, along with now former Allen County Commissioner Bill Brown. On the Democratic side, you've got Sharon Tucker, Gina Burgess, and Denny Springer, all good candidates, really, but I don't think, realistically, any of them have a likely chance of being elected, given the dramatic difference in vote total Tuesday night. I think the Republicans outvoted the Democrats 4-5-1.
And with three people who have been, in county government in some form or another before, so.
Right, yeah, so they've definitely got their work cut out in the campaign, but that's why we have campaigns, right? So if the Democrats can do it, more power to them. The turnout, Christian, on Tuesday was about 19%. Not great by any means, but not out of line with a lot of primaries that don't have a lot of sex appeal, as we had 4 years ago when the Democrats had Obama versus Hillary Clinton. Should we make too much of that, do you think, or is that simply what you get when you don't have a lot of interesting races?
Yeah, I don't think I'd make too much of that. I don't think it was too different from what we saw in 2010. And I think the vote totals, even in the Senate race, I think were pretty much the same as they were when Dan Coats ran in 2010. So I think it's pretty much what people expected, and it seems like we should have a lot stronger turnout when the presidential election comes up.
Right,
fall,
and so. We shouldn't necessarily put it all on the voters as well. You know, yes, we have a duty, if you want to put it that way, to vote, but I think the political parties also have an obligation to give the voters a lot of good contested races, which obviously we did not have on many parts of the ballot on Tuesday. A lot of the local races especially were unopposed, but not only local, at the federal level, Marlon Stutzman, the incumbent representative, was unopposed.
And the Democratic race for the 3rd Congressional District was pretty lopsided, too, as
right.
were most of the state house races in the area.
And also a governor, so we, it's not all on the voters, folks, and hopefully the parties will take that into account as well. Why don't we talk about the two school referendums briefly. Fort Wayne did win their $119 million referendum after failing at $500 million a few years ago. And East Allen, to no surprise really probably to anyone, failed in its attempt to get the $88 million referendum through, primarily for the New Haven area. Starting with Fort Wayne first, any surprise there, and what happens now? What do they have to do to assure the public that their money will be well spent?
Well, it seems like now, I mean, I think the task for them is just to start moving forward and getting those projects completed that they sold to voters as being, you know, important for the students. So,
right. And I might add, too, and I've written about it from time to time, but if I were a Fort Wayne school voter, and we know they're going to come back for phase two and phase three at some point, I would think they could assure me that the money will be well spent if they, you know, under the state common wage law, they actually vote to go with the lower minimum wage rather than demanding the higher union wage going in, which, according to some people, can increase the construction cost by up to 30%. I think that may be a little inflated, but even if only 10% would be saved by doing that, I think they would assure the voters that there's more care being given. In terms of East Allen, real quickly, we have less than a minute left. What about out there? What can they do now? Well, basically, you have no idea, and I think basically they don't either, which has been their problem. You know, they kind of got Heritage and Woodland, and now East Allen doesn't know what to do with New Haven and some of the rest of them. So, yeah, they definitely do have their work cut out for them. And with that, we'll leave you. For Christian Schekler, I'm Kevin Leininger, and be sure to check out our election coverage at www.news-sentinel.com. Thank you.